Good morning, children. Yesterday you have studied about basic proportionality theorem and its converse. Today we will discuss some questions which may be asked on the basis of basic proportionality theorem. Suppose that there is a triangle given ABC in which DE is parallel to BC. Now, here the value of AD is given 3 cm, value of DB is given 4 cm, value of AE is given 6 cm, and we have to find out the value of EC. Now we can solve it using basic proportionality theorem. As we are aware, in a triangle, if a line is parallel to any side in a triangle, then it divides the remaining two sides in a proportion, in equal ratio. Since in this triangle ABC, DE is a line segment which is parallel to BC, so it will divide the remaining two sides, AB and AC, in equal ratio. The ratio will be AD and DB and AE by EC. Now, since AD by DB is equal to AE by EC on the basis of basic proportionality theorem, now we'll put the value of the term which are known to us. The value of AD is known to us 3 cm, so we have written 3. DB is equal to 4 cm, we have written 4. Because while writing the ratio, units are generally cancelled out and they are not being written. So we have written for AE as 6 and EC as X. Now to find out the value of X, we will simplify it. We will take X in LHS and then by making the cross multiplication or taking 3 by 4 in RHS, we get 4 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator. So by taking X in the LHS, we see that 4 has been transferred to numerator and 3 has been transferred to denominator. With the simplification of it, we will get X is equals to 8 cm. So these type of questions may be asked on the basis of basic proportionality theorem, and as we have discussed you some corollary of PPT also, the questions may be asked on those also, so I am explaining you there. Now again we have to find out X over here. Now in this question also, D is parallel to BC and AD and DB are the segments in AB, and AE and EC are the segments in AC. Now the ratio of AD and DB and AE and EC are equals to each other, as we know by basic proportionality theorem. Now either you solve it by using BPT or the corollary of BPT. First we will solve it on the basis of corollary of BPT, and then further we will solve the same questions on the basis of BPT. Now see over here. In the first question, AD is equal to 3 cm given, and you have to find out the value of AB. That is the whole line segment, and AD is the upper line segment. Here again, AE, the upper line segment, is given, and the lower line segment is given. Now we will solve this question using corollary of BPT. As we have studied earlier, I have told you earlier in my previous class, corollary is actually the statement which can be obtained on the basis of the given statement or on the basis of the given theorem. A statement which can be obtained on the basis of a theorem, it is called corollary. in a very simple language you can understand it, that if we are having any statement, so on the basis of that statement, all the statements which are formed are called corollary of that statement. Here, these are the statements on the basis of basic proportionality theorem. It is that ratio of the upper line segment and the whole line segment is equal to the ratio of upper line segment and the whole line segment. It has been obtained on the basis of BPT. So it is called corollary of BPT. So AD by AB, AD is the upper line segment and AB is the whole line segment. It is known to us, it is 3 by X. And AE by AC, since we are having known both the segments, we know AE and EC both. AE and EC are the parts of AC. So AC can be expressed as the sum of AE and EC. So the value of AE was given 6 and the value of AC, as the AE and EC both were given, so we have added the value of AE and EC to get the value of whole line segment. Now what comes over here? The ratio of upper line segment and whole line segment is equal to the ratio of the upper line segment and the whole line segment of two different sides. Now on the basis of that, we can find out the value of X, that is equals to 7 centimeter. Now in the second question, we are having AB is equal to 7 centimeter, the whole line segment is 7 centimeter, and the lower line segment BD is equals to X centimeter, or simply X you can consider, and the lower line segment is EC is equals to 8 centimeter, and the whole line segment AC is equals to 14 centimeter. Now the second corollary which we have obtained over here, that the ratio of whole line segment and lower line segment is equal to the ratio of whole line segment and lower line segment of another side. It means that AB and AC are two different sides in which the ratio of AB, the whole line segment, and the lower line segment is equal to AC, the whole line segment, and the lower line segment. It means that AB by DB is equal to AC by EC. Since the value is unknown to us over here, all the three values, and EC is the unknown term, BD is the unknown term, so we will write down all that known value and the unknown term has been written as X. Now AB is the value of 7 centimeter and DB value as X, and the value of AC is 14 centimeter and value of EC is 8 centimeter. Now solving it, we can get the value of X is equals to 4 centimeter. We have solved these two questions on the basis of corollary of BPT, the things which we are based on BPT. If you want to solve it using BPT also, you can solve it. Solved. Now here we have solved the same question using BPT. What was given to us? AD, the upper line segment, and AB, the whole line segment, AE, the upper line segment, and AC, the lower line segment. Now we will use BPT, as we know that in a triangle, line drawn parallel to any side divides the remaining two sides in equal ratio. So these are the ratio of the sides which are remaining sides when DE is parallel to BC. AB has been divided into AD and BD. So the ratio of AD and BD is equal to the ratio of the division of AC, that is AE and EC. That was our BPT. Now we will put the value which are known to us. Now value of AD is known to us 3 cm. and the value of BD, we will obtain it with the difference of the whole line segment AB and AD. The difference of X and 3 will give us the value of BD. And the value of AE is known to us, that is 6 cm. And the value of EC is also known to us, 8 cm. Now, by doing the cross multiplication, we get 6x minus 18 is equal to 24. And further simplification will give us the value of X is equal to 7. Earlier we have used the corollary of BPT to solve this question, and here we have used BPT directly to solve the question. But here we have to take care that whenever we have to find out the segment, we have to do accordingly, as we have to find out BD over here. So what we have used the difference of AB and AD to express BD. So BD is equal to AB minus AD. So it has been expressed over here of X minus 3. The second question. In this one, AB, the whole line segment was given to us 7 cm. And BD, the lower line segment is X. EC, again the lower line segment EC is 8 cm. And the whole line segment AC is equal to 14 cm. Now, as we have obtained the same ratio of BPT, AB has been divided in the ratio of AD and BD, and AC has been divided in the ratio of AE and EC. Now, by putting the value of all the terms which are known to us, value of AD, AD can be obtained as the difference of AB and BD. Here, AB is 7 cm and BD is X. So, to find out AD, we will find out the difference of AB and BD to get it, and it is 7 minus X, and the value of BD is given X. Now, here the value of AE was given to us. AE was not given. We have to find out the value of AE. We can find out AE again using the difference of AC and EC. That have been explained over here, that the ratio of AE and EC is equal to 14 minus 8 by 8. This AE has been obtained with the difference of AC and EC. Now 14 minus 8 is equal to 6. Now we will do the cross multiplication to get the value 56 minus 8x is equal to 6x. Now I will solve it to get the value of X is equals to 4 cm. This minus 8X will be taken in RHS to become plus 8X. The sum of 6X and 8X will be equals to 14X, and the value of X is equals to 56 by 14, that is equals to 4. Now this question is based on the converse of BPT. The question is that find that MN is parallel to QR or not if in triangle PQR M and N are points on PQ and PR respectively, such that PN is equal to 4.8 cm, NR is equal to 1.6 cm, PM is equal to 4.5 cm and MQ is equal to 1.5 cm. Now we will solve it. We will first of all find out the ratio of PN and NR and PM and MQ. The value of PN was given to us 4.8 cm and the value of NR was given 1.6 cm. So we have expressed the value of it over here, and then we will express it in the standard form. It means that we will simplify it, and thus we get 3 by 1. The ratio of PN and NR in the simplest form is 3 is to 1. Now, we will find out the ratio of PM and MQ. The value of PM is given to us 4.5 centimeter, and the value of MQ is given 1.5 centimeter. Now again we will simplify it, and then we get the simplest form as 3 to 1. Now what do we observe? That both ratio of PN and NR and PM and MQ is equal to 3 to 1. It means that both are equal. Since in a triangle the ratio of the line segments are equal, then we can say that if we join the line segment, then this line segment will be parallel to the third line segment. Therefore, the ratio of PM and MQ is equal to the ratio of PN and NQ, NR. Therefore, we can say that MN is parallel to QR. It is the converse of basic proportionality theorem, that if in a triangle the ratio of any two sides are equal, then the line segment joining the points is parallel to the third side. Now we are going to discuss one more theorem, which is based on the basic proportionality theorem. It is also very important theorem, which is called internal angle bisector theorem. Though the question is being asked from you simply in this form, which is the statement of the internal angle bisector theorem, that proves that in a triangle the internal bisector of an angle divides the opposite sides in two segments that are proportional to the other two sides of the triangle. Here we see that AD is the angle bisector of angle A, and this angle bisector divides the opposite side BC in two segments BD and DC. Now we have to prove that the ratio of BD and DC is equal to the ratio of AB and AC. Now for that we will do some construction. Here the things which are given to us: a triangle ABC in which AD bisects angle BAC intersecting BC at D. And what we have to prove? We have to prove that ratio of AB and AC is equal to the ratio of BD and DC. To solve it, we will do some construction by ourselves. We will draw a line EC parallel to AD, which cuts extension of BA at E. You can see it in the figure over here. We are having a triangle ABC. This is a triangle in which AD is the angle bisector of angle BAC. What we have done in our construction? We have drawn a line parallel from point C, which on extension of BA cut each other at E. Here DA is parallel to EC, and this EC is intersecting extension of BA at E. Now it will form a triangle EBC. Now since it is given that AD bisects angle BAC, so we can say that this angle is equal to this angle. It is our equation number 1. We have shown it in equation number 1 that AD bisects angle BAC. Therefore, we can say that angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. Now, after that, we see that we are having two lines parallel to each other. Now, on the basis of that, we can say that these two angles are corresponding pair of angles. So we can say that this angle is equal to this angle because they are corresponding pair of angle. Now these two angles are corresponding pair of angles. So these two are also equal because these lines are parallel to each other. Now we see that this angle is equal to this angle earlier, and this angle is also equal to this angle because they are the corresponding pair of angles. Because in our construction we have assumed ourselves that these two lines are parallel to each other. Now what do we observe? Again we are having a pair of parallel line and a line intersecting in this way. Thus we can have alternate pair of angle also equal to each other. These two angles are alternate pair of angles. Now we see that this angle is equal to this angle. Why these two angles are equal to each other? Because this line is parallel to this line and these two angles are alternate pair of angles. Now it has been shown in equation number 1, 2 and 3 over here. Here what we have shown? We have shown that angle BAD is equal to angle AEC. Why they are equal to each other? Because they are corresponding pair of angles. And angle CAD is also equal to angle ACE. Why they are equal? Because they are alternate pair of angles. Now when we see equation 1, 2 and 3, we see that all angles are equal to each other. Here all four angles are equal to each other. It shows that angle ACE will be equal to angle AEC. And as we have studied in standard 9 property, that in a triangle, if two angles are equal, then the sides opposite to them are also equal. So since angle ACE is equal to angle AEC, we can say that AE is equal to AC. Now we will take complete triangle BEC, the whole triangle BEC. Now this whole triangle BEC, what do we see? That this AD is parallel to EC. We are having simply this figure now. Since this side is parallel to this side, we see that in triangle BEC, this AD is parallel to EC. Now we know by BPT that ratio of BA and AE, the two segments, are equal to the ratio of the other two segments of the line. Therefore, ratio of BA and AE will be equal to BD and DC. Here now we see that in triangle BEC, the ratio of BA and AE is equal to BD by DC. But as we have proved that AE is equal to AC, so for AE we can write AC. That we have done over here. Now in triangle BEC, AD is parallel to EC. So using BPT, we can say that ratio of BA and AE is equal to the ratio of BD and DC. But as we have proved earlier that this AE is equal to AC, so we can write that ratio of AB and AC is equal to BD by DC, BD and DC. That we have to prove. Now this is internal bisector theorem, which is based on BPT. It is very important question. Now after understanding this theorem, you can solve exercise 6.2, because in exercise 6.2 of NCERT these things are given, and you will try to solve all the questions of exercise 6.2. and if you have any problem, you may ask from us.